So the addressing modes are very important to understand the programming concepts of your 8051. Okay. So next we are going to see about how to program your PS3, that is PSW.3 and PSW.4. Okay, that is how to program your band selection using PSW register. Okay. So here the problem statement, write a program to save the accumulator in R7 of bank 2. Okay, so we need to transfer the content of accumulator into R7 of your bank 2. Okay, so before that you have to select this bank 2 segment in your internal RAM memory. So bank selection can be done by using PSW register. Okay, so look at this. So how many flags involved in PSW? So this is the content of your PSW. So we have 4 flags: carry flag, auxiliary carry, overflow and parity. So these 4 flags are mathematical flags. And also we have user flag, one user flag. So using this bit, we can set or reset the user flag status. And these 2 are mainly used for selecting your bands, register bands. Okay. So according to your ALU result, your mathematical flags will be affected. Okay. So based on the results of ALU, so these flags are automatically set or reset by your 8051 microcontroller or hardware. Okay. And we can program these 2 bits, that is PSW.3 and PSW.4. Okay, so we can program these 2 bits to select our register banks. Okay, so what are the combination to select your bank registers? So 00 means which bank is selected?
Bank 0.
Bank 0. So these 2 bits are programmable. User can access these 2 bits, okay, by using your 8051 instruction. Okay, so 00 means your bank. So 00, bank 0 select. 01, bank 1 selected. 10, bank 2. 11, bank 2. So next we will see how to program these 2 bits. Okay, so what is the problem statement given? So you have to save the accumulator content in R7 of your bank 2. So how do you select your bank 2?
10.
You have one to write 10 in PSW.3 and PSW.4. okay. So we have to write 1 second. One Z. Okay. So to select your register bands, okay, to make other bits are 0. So this is for your future modification and use of this zero, default value zero, okay? So based on the ALU results, your mathematical flags set are reset automatically by your 8051 microcontroller. We cannot access these flag status. User side, we cannot modify the content of your carry flag status, auxiliary carry flag status, overflow flag status, and parity. We cannot touch these flags. Only we can access these three bits. User side, we can access these three bits, and this is for user flag zero, and these two for your bank selection. Okay, according to the problem, RS1 must be 1 and RS0 0. So what is the content of PSW now? 0001
1 0
So programming this register, we can move this value to your PSW register. Move PSW comma hash 10. Okay. Or individually we can access these two bits by using two instruction: clear PSW 0.3. Since your PSW is a bit addressable register, so we can access the individual bits. Okay, so individual bits can be accessed. So using this one, clear PSW 0.3, used to clear this RS0 0. And next, set bit PSW 0.4. So this instruction used to set this bit as 1. Okay. So after execution of these two instruction, your bank true will be selected. So in this way, we can program our bank selection using PSW register. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So your first instruction, first you have to sum value into accumulator a comma hash 07. Now your accumulator holds 07 hexadecimal value. Next we have to select our bank. So the bank to be selected here is bank 2. So clear PSW 0.3 and set bit PSW 0.4. So these two instructions are used to select your bank 2 of your internal RAM. So after that, you have to move the accumulator content to your R7H. So now your accumulator content is transferred to the R7 of bank 2. So in this way, we can access your bank 1, bank 2, bank 3 registers. Okay, default bank selection is bank 0. So remaining banks can be selected by using this PSW register. And instead of these two, you can have this instruction also. Move PSW comma, what is the answer? 10. Instead of these two, either you can move 8-bit data or individual bits can be accessed. Now, is that clear, ma'am? Any doubts?
Ma'am, this individual accessing of bits, is it from right to left or left to right in the position? 0.3, 0.4.
0.3 is from your right to left, that is D0 to. This is D0, right? D0, D1, D2, D3. Okay? D4, D5, D6, D7. Likewise. Right to left. Any other doubts? So let's execute this code in our simulator. A comma hash 07H. Okay. Yeah, according to your RAM arrangement. Okay. So first one is your bank zero. See, look at this diagram. You can understand clearly. So this is your bank arrangement. Okay. Bank zero. The starting address 00. And end address 07. We have 8 registers. Bank 1, 0A to 0F. Okay. So for this is the internal address 08. Similarly, for this one, 09. Likewise, every register is associated with 1 8-bit address. In this way, your registers are arranged in your internal RAM. Bank 2, 10 to 17. And 18 to 1F. This order you have to follow here. Okay. So this row is your bank 0. The starting address is 00. Neenga inga paathina theriyum 002. What is the end address? 07. So this 00 is nothing but your R0. And this 07 is nothing but your R7 of bank 0. Okay. So next one is the bank 1. What is the starting address? 08 is the starting address. So 08 is the starting address. End address 0F. So end address 0F. And third row for bank 2. And fourth row for bank 3. Likewise, all your bank registers are arranged in this window. That is internal RAM memory window. Okay. So let's execute this code. So first look at here, your accumulator is loaded with 07. Okay. And next, clear PSW.3. Here R S not reset. Okay. Clear. That is PSW.3 is cleared. Okay. So this red indication to indicate that RS1 is set to 1. So your RS0 is cleared and RS1 is 1. So 10. So your bank 2 will be selected. Okay. Bank 2 will be selected. Okay. So which row is your bank 2? So first row is the bank 0. Second one is the bank 1. And third one is the bank 2. So what is this instruction? I'm going to transfer accumulator content to R7 of your bank 2. Okay. So after execution, here, please look at here. See, this is your bank 2. So I'm transferring accumulator content to R7 of your bank 2. So 07 is transferred to R7 of your bank 2 register. Okay. Is that clear? So here look at the RS. RS1 is set to 1 and RS0 is set to 0. Is that clear, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts? Other students? You have any doubts? Programming your bank selection? Okay. So do this one. So try this problem. Write an instruction to use the registers of bank 3 and load the same value 05 in the registers R0 to R3. So write a program for this statement, problem statement. Please do it. So you have to select your bank 3 using PSW register. So first you write the statement for bank selection. Have you completed?
Yes, ma'am.
So put your answers in the chat box. வருதுல்லங்க சார் ரெட் பண்ணு ஓகே சார் So what value to be loaded into PSW? Okay, set bit PSW 0.3, set bit PSW 0.4. Okay, after that, so what is the problem statement given? R0, load the same value 05 in the registers R0 to R7. Okay, R0. You have to load 05 into R0, not A, R0.
Ma'am, first we have to load the value to accumulator.
Yeah, first you have to load the value into accumulator. First load 05 into accumulator and move the value in the corresponding registers. That is R0, R1, R2 and R3. 203 correct. See, so first you have to select your bank selection. For that, you make PSW 0.41 and PSW 0.31. So these two instructions are used to select your bank 3. And load your accumulator with the value of 05 and move your accumulator content to R0 and R1, R2, R3. Okay, So this is the one way of writing. Other way, you have to find out the PSW value. PSW 0.3. So this is 0.3 and this is 0.4. So, okay. So what is the value? 1.8.
8, ma'am.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Yes. So either instead of these two instruction, you can use move PSW comma hash 18. So both the instructions take 2 bytes of memory. For set bit 1 byte, again set bit 1 byte. Suppose if you are using move PSW comma hash 18, the same instruction takes 2 bytes of memory location. Is that clear? Please note down the answer. Harish Kumar, correct. Have you all noted? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next, just you analyze this program. So already I have explained. So your register banks are arranged in this way. For bank 0 starting address 00 to 07, bank 1 08 to F, bank 2 10 to 17, bank 3 18 to 1. Okay, so here clear bit PSW 0.3. So PSW 0.31 and PSW 0.30, PSW 0.41. So which bank is selected? 10 means bank 4. Yes. Yes. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So bank 2 was selected. So this bank is selected. Bank 2 is selected according these two instructions. Okay. So what is the next instruction? Move R0 comma hash 99. So after execution, what will be the content of R0?
99.
So your 10, your memory location 10 has a value of 99. So that is the meaning. So your 10 is nothing but your R0 of bank 2. Is that clear? So first, according to the first two instruction, bank 2 will be selected. I am moving 99 into R0. R0 is nothing but, that is an internal address of your R0 is 10. So after execution, your R0 holds 99. R0 of which bank? Bank 2. And this R0 can be accessed by using this 8-bit address also. So internal memory, your 10 has this 99. So both the statements are same. Is that clear? Suppose move R1 comma 85. After execution, this R1, bank 2 R1 holds 85, which means your 10 memory location 1 1. Okay, 1 1 has this data. So this register can be accessed either by register name or by address. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what is the another problem given here? State the contents of RAM location after the execution of following instruction. Find out. State the content of RAM memory location. You have to identify the memory location, not register.
Ma'am, we have to search for it in which bank?
Yeah, suppose if the problem is given in your exam, okay. So in this case, the no PSW details are given, okay. So which bank is selected in default?
Zero.
Bank zero.
So you have to choose your bank zero.
Okay.
99.
Suppose more information is given means you can take bank zero. Huh? So after execution of your first memory location, what is your RAM content memory, ma'am, memory location?
Zero, ma'am.
Zero. So your 00 holds 99. And R1, that is 01, holds 85. And next R2, your 02 holds 3F. Okay. Answer. So I will write the answer here, okay. 00, we have 99. 01, 85. Okay. So what is the address for R2? 02, 3F. R7 address? 0763. Okay. R5 address 0511. So in this way, your data, 8-bit data, are moved into your corresponding memory location. Okay. Suppose the PSW information is not given in your program, you have to select your bank zero. Okay. So that's all about your PSW programming. Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
No.
So shall we move on to the next topic, instruction set?
Yes, ma'am.
So based on the operation they perform, all the instruction in 8051 are divided into 5 groups. So first group is the data transfer. Okay. And next one, arithmetic group. Third one is the logical group. And fourth one we have bit manipulation instruction. So this is the unique feature of your 8051 compared to your 8086 instructions and program branching instructions. Okay. So this is the entire your instruction set group. So this table shows the 8051 instruction groups, okay, and instructions in each group. So data transfer, we have these instructions. Arithmetic, we have these instructions like logical, Boolean and programming. Boolean is nothing but bit manipulation instruction. So there are 49 instructions, totally 49 mnemonics, okay, in 8051 microcontroller. And these 49 mnemonics are divided into 5 groups. Okay, we will see one by one. So your first group is the data transfer group. So data transfer group consisting of these instructions. That is simple move instruction, that is copying data from source to destination operand. And what is this move C?
Core memory.
Core memory, accessing data bytes from core memory. And move X is accessing data byte from external memory. And these two instructions are for mainly stack operations. Okay. And these two for exchanging data bytes. Okay. First, we will see about the simple move instruction. I think already you are aware of this instruction. So can I ask question? Role number one, can you explain the first instruction? What is that?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you explain that first one? Move A comma. So these instructions already we have used in our labs. Some of the instruction I have to explain. Move A comma hash data. What is the operation of this instruction?
Ma'am, the data specified will be moved to the accumulator.
Okay, this data was 8-bit data or 16-bit data?
8-bit, ma'am.
8-bit data. Okay, since your destination register is a 8-bit register, you have to specify 8-bit data here. Suppose if you are specifying 16-bit data, that data will not be accepted. That case, that instruction is an invalid instruction. Okay. So we are transferring 8-bit data into accumulator, and addressing mode is the immediate addressing mode, and it requires 2 bytes of memory location, and machine cycle required 1. Please note it down. These informations are very important. Okay. Actually, the move instruction transfers data between your accumulator. Okay. Look at first 4 sentence, 4 instructions. Accumulator will be your destination register. And next RN, okay, next direct address, next indirect address, okay. So it transfer data between accumulator and register, between accumulator, register, between accumulator and internal memory, and data directly into the accumulator, register R0 to R7, R to internal memory. So in this way, they have classified this move instruction, okay. So move A comma hash data is a immediate addressing mode instruction. So it requires 2 bytes of addressable memory and number of machine cycle required. That is, machine cycle to execute this instruction is 1 machine cycle. Okay, based on your internal clock frequency of your 8051 microcontroller, this clock cycles are determined. Okay, what is the second instruction? Move A comma RN, roll number 2.
The 8-bit data present in the register is moved to the accumulator.
So what does N indicate here?
N represents the registers 0 to 7.
Yeah, 0 to 7. N represents 0 to 7. So we can have any bank register here. That is bank 0 register, bank 1 register, bank 2 and bank 3. So N can vary from 0 to 7. Okay. So this addressing mode is register addressing mode. Why it is called as a register addressing mode?
Because the data is present in the register.
Well, data, not data. So register addressing mode means we are talking about some register names. Okay. So register names are directly specified in the instruction. So this instruction, solo Henry, one second, ma. Okay, what is this? So why this addressing mode is register addressing mode? The name of the register is specified in the instruction. Okay, number of bytes required 1, number of bytes required 1, and number of clock cycle required 1. So what is the third instruction? move A comma direct roll number 3. What is the direct? Move A comma direct.
Memory location is direct addressed directly.
Okay, so this direct address is internal memory or external memory? So move A comma direct. Internal. What is the size of your internal memory? 8 bit or 16 bit?
8 bit ma.
8 bit. Actually, register banks, you look at this diagram, that is bank register diagram, you can see the address size is 8 bit. Okay. So the internal RAM memory content is transferred to accumulator. Okay. So move RN comma direct means you can give any internal address, RAM address here. Move RN comma 40H. So the operation is the content of 40 is transferred to accumulate the register banks. That is the content of 40 is 01. So that is transferred to your register bank. Here N represent 0 to 7. So we can transfer the internal RAM memory content to register banks using this register, using this instruction. Is it clear? So what is the next instruction? Move A comma at RI. Attari. Roll number 4.
Yes, ma'am.
What is move A comma attari?
The source address is given in the register, ma'am. Then
okay.
The data present at that address will be stored in the accumulator, ma'am.
So what is the meaning of that at?
It is a pointer, ma'am. It indicates that
actually this instruction is used to move the data from internal RAM whose address is in R1 or R0 register to accumulator. Okay, so the syntax is move A comma at RI. Okay, so this RI is nothing but either your R0 register or R1 register. Okay, so the data pointed by RI is transferred to accumulator. So the addressing mode is indirect addressing mode. If direct address is specified in the instruction, that addressing mode is the direct addressing mode. Suppose if the address is specified indirectly, so that addressing mode is called indirect addressing mode. Okay. So we will see the remaining instruction in the next class. Okay. So any doubts up to this? The remaining are very simple instructions. So next class we will discuss the remainder. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.